So hey guys, this is Jill from TotalDistortion.com and I'm here with
Robert from Boysetsfire. Thanks for watching. Thanks for coming, Jill.
Yeah, sure, no problem. So how are you doing?
We're doing great and beautiful. Well, outside of beautiful Milano today, and I wish we would be a little closer, because that way I would have gone sightseeing a little bit. But from what I understand, we're a little removed from the city center. But it's still fun. A little boxing going on by the sick of it all, guys. Here, there's some band sound checking, so everything's going according to plan.
Yeah. So when did you guys get here? So you didn't really have a chance to go around the city or anything.
Not so much. We got here. Yesterday we had a very, very hectic day. We were in Germany, but we flew out to London to do the BBC Radio 1 sessions.
Okay.
It's kind of a dream come true for us
to
play there. And so we flew to London, did that, flew right back to Frankfurt, and then drove all night to Milano. And then got up this morning and we're stranded here. And, so yeah, I mean, I guess we could have taken a train or something, but it's just one of those tour things. You're like, wake up, where's food, where's this, where's that?
Yeah. And you just try to like relax.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. Like we're doing right now.
Yeah, yeah, exactly, for sure. So you guys are currently on your Europe tour.
Yes.
But you have also played a few festivals, such as Greenfield Festival, Sunset Festival in Germany, and Turkey Festival. How do you guys enjoy those shows?
Oh, and all the shows right now are pretty amazing, because people are, reaction to them, to our new record is beyond what we had. I mean, we were hoping for the record to be received well, but we didn't. We had no idea how well it would be received.
Yeah.
People love it, and we're grateful for that.
Yeah.
But you never know. You just do a record that you like, then you throw it out there and hope for the best. But it's been pretty awesome. Like all those festivals and stuff, so many people, and also so many new people checking us out. And that's pretty crazy for a band that's been around for a minute.
Yeah, for sure. Well, when you guys are playing those bigger festivals, is that something you really enjoy? I mean, you really have a much bigger crowd, and I mean, it's a great way for you for music to be exposed to new people all the time as well. But I can imagine it's a very stressful procedure. I mean, you don't have sound checks, so you just kind of go out there. Versus having your own show where you kind of have your sound check, you can really organize your things your way. So is that something that you enjoy, the type of thrill? Or
I think that it's nice to have both.
Uh-huh.
You know, like, it's nice to have like a German club show with like 1,500 people, and then you have a festival with like 60,000 people, and then you have a show like today with maybe, I don't know, 600.
Yeah.
I think that whole range is nice to have. Because each show brings something forth that the other doesn't. Like with a festival, for example, people are pretty far away.
Yeah.
And I personally like it when people are like in my face grabbing me and like I grab them and stuff. But then again, it's nice to play with other great bands that are not from our musical genre. Like some of my favorite bands, Sigur Rós, Portishead, Tegan and Sarah, all played with us at Southside and Hurricane. So I got done playing, showered real quick, and then ran over to Tegan and Sarah and wiggled my head. It was like a, you know, like a little fanboy. I was like, oh, so cute. You know, like that.
Yeah, so you do have time to, when you're at those festivals, to check out some other bands.
Yeah.
So what kind of bands are you into at the moment?
Well, like I said, we were all, our crew, our band, we all love Portishead.
Mm-hmm.
So they were amazing. Our guitarist said it's the best show he's ever seen. I think privately. Like for real. Like actually shed tears because they were so good.
Yeah.
They were amazing. And then as for myself, like I love Tegan and Sarah. I discovered this new band that everyone seems to know about, The National.
Okay.
That they're great guys too.
Uh-huh.
I met them and so yeah, I mean there's always stuff to check out, stuff to do, and be too boring to only sit on the bus. So
if there's
good music being played, why not?
Yeah. Do you feel like you draw your own inspiration for your own music also from other artists? If so, which ones?
Well, I think it's very individually different in our band. We draw influences from not only like other musicians, but like you said, other artists, like books, or you know, like I can always carry my little paperback around, read
What's
as much
that?
Of it. Well, this is a Paul Auster novel
okay.
that I'm reading right now, but I'm almost done with it, and the next one is already waiting. So
okay,
I always try to use the free time on tour to do that. But yeah, I mean, of course, we all have different, like I'm, for example, the biggest like George Harrison fan in the world, right? So the Beatles and George Harrison or Bob Marley for me are just very like special influences, but there's tons of stuff. I don't listen to that much heavy music, so sometimes kids are a little disappointed because they come up to me and like, do you love this band and this band? I'm very old school when it comes to music. Like, I don't dislike those bands, I just kind of already have a lot of things that I like and just not so good at keeping up with the current scene.
Yeah.
But once in a while there's a great band coming along, and once in a while we're able to bring in older fans that we love, like Bane, who are touring with us right now, like old Boston hardcore, the way it should be done, in my opinion. Because I don't really see Boysetsfire as a hardcore band, personally.
Yeah.
I just see it more like... rock music, I don't even know, but Bane for me is like, or Sick of It All.
Yeah.
That's like real hard to make. I love watching that.
The bands that you guys tour with, is that something that you pick?
No, everything we do, we pick.
Okay.
Boysetsfire is weird like that. We don't allow any outside influence.
Okay.
It's
do your own thing.
Always. Like the artwork, the lyrics, the music, we have our own label, everything. We have the last say in it. And it has to be like that because we're a very complicated band that kind of knows what we want and what we don't want.
Because you guys do have your own record label, and
yes.
Record.
Mm-hmm.
So how did that come about? Because I know your previous records, you did have some, with your previous record label, you had some issues and stuff, so...
Well, it was...
what knows, anyway? I mean, why did you decide to...
Yeah, you could say that we're label whores, you know? Like, we just always, like, we never did a release on the same record. Twice, back to back. So, we're just like I said, we're, I think we're very, like, down-to-earth, normal dudes, but we do actually know what we want and what we don't want, especially what we don't want. And a lot of the stuff that comes along with being in a band, you know, like what labels or in art people think you have to do, we just don't feel like doing.
Yeah.
It's just that kind of thing. You know, you have other bands, and God bless them, but they're willing to do whatever it takes to get to that next level. We don't even care about the next level. We're best friends. Yeah, and we're just that kind of band. Right?
Yeah.
You know? Which I think makes our band very authentic and very
real.
But it makes our band a nightmare for everyone who wants to kind of follow different marketing schemes and you have to play this TV show, you have to do this or that. And our answer is always the same. You don't have to do anything.
Now that you've released your new record, Well and She Sleeps, on your own record label, do you feel like it's a little bit harder to promote your music and to kind of get it out there? Or are you really happy to just sort of have that freedom and really you're just like, fuck it?
Very happy. Even if there is some repercussions, I haven't noticed yet, and I'm very excited about putting it out ourselves.
Yeah. And you also recorded the new record in a home studio, so that must have been nice to sort of...
Like I said, it wasn't mine. Everything we do is really just... You know, all the shirt designs you see are done by us or with close friends.
Who comes up with those? Who's like the artistic one?
Well, I mean, we all do, but Nathan is kind of like, I think he came up with a friend of ours together and came up with the whole like Freemason symbols and stuff that I really enjoy because I love like secret societies and that kind of thing. And we just wanted to, the artwork and the shirts and everything, wanted to focus on, I mean, as you see with the Sickle Toll shirts and the Bane shirts in the background, you guys can't see it, but they're there, I promise. there's like the band people on there and stuff,
We
just wanted to go a different way. So it's not that much about us as people, it's more about the unit and the music.
So now you also feel that you have a closer relationship with your fans, like even interacting through social media, like you all do that on your own.
Yeah, I mean, we've just recently started doing that more.
Yeah.
Kind of always a little behind, you know? Other bands have done that for so long, and we kind of like... But we do try to like keep everyone updated with our plans, and that's growing slowly but surely, and we try to do as much as we can in the time that we have, so...
Yeah. All right, you're going to be continuing your European tour until July? So you've also released your record, so you've been pretty busy so far this year.
Yeah.
So what's the plans for the rest of the year?
We're gonna finish this tour, and I think it's two more weeks. of, like, we don't do day offs, it's not planned. So it's a show every day,
yeah,
which is fun, it's kind of how we like it. And then we do Australia later that year, and there's been talk about maybe doing China, perhaps, and do more shows in the US, of course, also, and then coming back to Europe at some point. So we're gonna stay busy. The band is not gonna break up anytime soon. Thing. It did that and it didn't work. So
yeah, you like
me. Try to, yeah, we're like, you know, we're like that. Yeah, we're like that couple where you're like, really, you broke up, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Now we just decided, you know, if someone of us wants a break, then we're gonna take a break. But yeah, Boysetsfire is not going away. Taking the time to everybody watching, supporting Boysetsfire and the other